This screencast discusses the three types of atomic bonding and their purpose in terms of material properties. And we finally end up with an example of types of atomic bonding. So the first question is, why do atoms bond? And the reason is to lower their overall energy. And this happens at a particular spacing between the atoms. So we have three types of atomic bonding. The first type is known as ionic, and this is between a metal and a non-metal. And in this particular type of bonding, we have a transfer of electrons. The second type is covalent bonding, and in this type, we have sharing of electrons. Finally, we have what's known as metallic bonding, and here we have the valence electrons, and in metals, there aren't that many valence electrons, and they drift through the entire metal. And this has been described as a sea of electrons. Here's an example of what metallic bonding would look like. You have these ion cores in here that are positively charged because they don't have their valence electrons. And all throughout here, you have these electrons, these negative charges that are floating throughout the entire metal. So this table sums up the type of bonding. Notice the transfer versus the sharing of electrons, the difference in electronegativities versus the comparable negativities. But one term that we haven't discussed is directional. And this is when bonded atoms prefer specific orientations. In other words, they have a definite shape. And if you look at the different types of bonding, you notice the only type of bonding that is directional is covalent. And hopefully you remember your Vesper structures, etc., from chemistry. So generally, there is a combination of bondings. You don't have something that is 100% one way or the other, or you rarely do. And if we look at a combination of ionic and covalent bonding, you can tell the percent of ionic character with the following equation. And here, the XA or the XB are the electronegativities that can be found on Pauling's chart of electronegativities. So let's look at an example here. If we're given electronegativities of chlorine and sodium, we want to rank the bonds in HCl, sodium chloride, and Cl2 from most covalent to most ionic. And looking at those, the most covalent bond is going to be Cl2, and the next is going to be HCl, finally followed by sodium chloride. And how we got this is in the differences in the electronegativities. So now let's look at the percent ionic character. And we can tell in Cl2, because there is no difference in the electronegativities, the percent ionic character is zero. However, let's look now at HCl. And this is going to be equal to 1 minus the exponential of negative 0.25 times 0.9 squared times 100, which is going to equal about 18% ionic. Finally, we'll look at sodium chloride, which is 1 minus the exponential of negative 0.25 times the difference squared, 2.1 squared times 100, and that's going to equal 67% ionic. So this is just an introduction to the atomic bonding, and in later screencasts we'll talk about how these kinds of bondings affect material properties.